Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a circuit that senses temperature using a positive temperature coefficient, or PTC, thermistor. This schematic represents a temperature sensing circuit for a PTC thermistor. A PTC thermistor has a positive temperature coefficient, which means its resistance increases with temperature. A resistor in series with a PTC thermistor forms a resistor divider. A change in temperature changes the PTC resistance, which changes the input voltage, Vin. Vin is amplified by a non-inverting amplifier. A reference voltage, Vref, offsets the gain, which helps utilize the full output swing of the op-amp. The equation for VO is the transfer function of the circuit. The first term, VDD times RPTC divided by R1 plus RPTC, is the input voltage, Vin. The second term, R3 plus R2 divided by R2, represents the non-inverting gain of the amplifier circuit. Finally, the third term, Vref times negative R3 divided by R2, represents the reference voltage times the inverting gain of the amplifier. The first goal of this circuit is to output a voltage of 50 millivolts at a minimum temperature of 0 degrees Celsius, and to output a voltage of 3.25 volts at the maximum temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. This output voltage range, from 50 millivolts to 3.25 volts, will maximize the linear output voltage swing of the amplifier using a single 3.3 volt supply. The first design step is to calculate the resistance of R1. This is done by taking the square root of the sum of the PTC resistance at 50 degrees Celsius and 0 degrees Celsius. This equates to a resistance of 9.95 kiloohms. The next closest standard value is 10 kiloohms, so we will use this value for the design as shown by R1 in the schematic. Now that we know the input voltage divider resistances, the next step is to calculate the maximum and minimum input voltage range. The maximum input voltage is calculated using the PTC resistance at 50 degrees Celsius. The minimum input voltage is calculated using the PTC resistance at 0 degrees Celsius. The maximum input voltage is calculated to be 1.773 volts, and the minimum input voltage is calculated to be 1.519 volts. The next step is to calculate the ideal non-inverting gain required to produce an output voltage from 50 millivolts to 3.25 volts, given the input voltage range calculated on the previous slide. The non-inverting gain is calculated by dividing the output voltage swing by the input voltage swing. The value is calculated as 12.598 volts per volt. The non-inverting gain is set by resistors R2 and R3 and is calculated with the equation gain equals R2 plus R3 divided by R2. Choosing a standard resistor value of 1 kiloohm for R2 allows us to calculate a resistor value of 11.598 kiloohms for R3. Since 11.598 kiloohms is not a standard resistor value, we will use the next closest value of 11.5 kiloohms, as shown in the schematic. Since our ideal gain cannot be realized with standard resistors, we need to calculate the actual gain we will get using standard resistor values. The actual gain of our circuit is calculated as 12.5 volts per volt. Next, we need to calculate the output voltage swing based on the actual gain of the circuit. The output voltage swing is calculated as the maximum input voltage minus the minimum input voltage multiplied by the actual gain. The output voltage swing is calculated as 3.175 volts. Now that we know the output voltage swing, we need to calculate the maximum output voltage when the output voltage is symmetrical around mid-supply so that we can calculate the reference voltage, Vref, for the circuit. The maximum output voltage is calculated as 3.238 volts. This calculation can also be done using the minimum output voltage. Using the transfer function of the circuit, we can now calculate the reference voltage required for the design. For the calculation, we will use the maximum output voltage, maximum input voltage, and actual gain. Solving the transfer function for VREF, we calculate the reference voltage to be 1.646 volts. This simulation shows a sweep of the temperature from 0 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. The output voltage ranges from 59 millivolts to 3.239 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. Running an AC sweep analysis, we find that the bandwidth of the circuit is 84 kHz. When designing a temperature sensing circuit with a PTC thermistor, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, the resistor, R1, is chosen based on the temperature range and the PTC's value. Next, be sure to always check the linear output swing of the amplifier, which is usually given in the condition section of the AOL datasheet specification. Finally, the reference voltage, VREF, can be created using a DAC or voltage divider. However, if a voltage divider is used, the equivalent resistance of the voltage divider will influence the gain of the circuit, so it should be buffered with an op amp. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a temperature sensing circuit with a PTC thermistor. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.